down. So let's talk about shoulders, right? Since we just finished, or we're about to finish shoulders this week, we have a call on Thursday, and we're gonna go over labrum and all the testing that is related to shoulders. One of the things that I always like to do is, you know, instead of sitting there and reading some of the most boring chapters, the first five chapters, I always joke, yes, you wanna start somewhere, you start with chapter one, right? Which is anatomy and kinematics, but man, that stuff is really dry. It's so dry. And one of the things I do is I chunk up that information so that you can actually bypass that, those chapters. But we want to break it up into shoulders. Want to go into anterior muscles, rotator cuff muscles, and then posterior muscles, right? And then one of the things I like to do is I like to list out the muscles. So if I take the muscles and I break down anterior, posterior, and rotator cuff. So most of us already know rotator cuff is your supraspinatus, your infraspinatus, your subscap, and your teres minor, right? It's important not just to know the muscles, we don't need to get super detailed with origin insertion. What is most important when you're reading the chapters is to know, okay, if it originates here and it ends here, then what happens when something goes wrong, right? How does this muscle affect when something goes wrong, right? So we know for the most part our rotator cuffs are these muscles, and these are our dynamic stabilizers, right? If something goes wrong with these four muscles, we lose some stability. And the shoulder's already lacking a certain amount of stability, right? So then our anterior muscles, we have our pecs, we have our pec minor, right? We have our coracobrachialis, I'm just gonna shorten it there. We have our biceps, we have our deltoids, and even with the deltoids, we have 1, 2, and 3, right? And then when it comes to our posterior muscles, we have our traps, and we have three parts of that too. We have our triceps, we have our rhomboids, we have our levator scapulae, we have our teres major, we have our lats, and then we have our serratus anterior, right? So let's say you're studying all of the shoulders. One of the things I like to do is I like to chunk that information up and really talk about not just what happens normally, but then what happens abnormally. So which muscles are the culprit? Like where are your problem child? Where are your problem child? So yes, any of these muscles can be broken, but isn't this one of the most common ones, right? When it comes to shoulders, we have to know about the dynamics of like how the scapula moves. Who's our problem child here? We know that a lot of times it could be the serratus anterior, right? We know that it could be a lot of times the traps. And then in the anterior, we know that sometimes the pecs minor can give us problems, and believe it or not, the biceps too. And the deltoids, so many problem child, but it's really important when you're studying to really focus in on what do you need to know as a certified hand therapist? So write that question down. What do I need to know as a certified hand therapist? Because it's not that you need to know everything. So that's where the overwhelm is, like, oh my God, I need to know everything. You need to know a certain percentage so that you can rule in and rule out questions on the exam. You need to be able to rule in and rule out questions on the exam and pick the best answer, right? And everything really, for the most part, comes out of rehab of the hand. And that's literally, essentially, where I teach from, right? So if we break down shoulders, then we can go into elbows, right? So we're gonna tie it all together in a way in terms of anatomy. So if you take a look at your elbow, you have your biceps, you have your brachii, you have your radiobrachialis, you have your triceps, right? So these are your proximal elbow muscles, right? So some of them, like here, the biceps actually crosses, you know, the biceps and the triceps, they essentially cross the shoulder and goes to the elbow, affects the elbow. So like Yeah, we need to know muscles, we need to know ligaments, we need to know bone, or like, we already know the bones, but we need to know what happens to them, right? What happens to when they break, when they dislocate and stuff like that. So really important to know which muscles too, cross where and who are the problem child, right? So then we can go into wrists. So here are our wrist extensors. You have your ECRB, your ECRL, and your ECU, right? Then you have your wrist flexors, your FCU, your FCR, your palmaris longus, and so forth, right? So once you break down the wrist extensors, then you can go into hands. And one of the things, I have this one really powerful video where it really dives into the anatomy of it and breaks the information down. So you can really think through extensor, you know, extrinsic muscles, right? And intrinsic muscles. Where are the problems? So everything about this program, the hand exam prep program, is really about how can we, you know, prepare for the CHT without all that overwhelm.
Hey therapy friends, it's Hoang here. Thanks again for watching my video. And if you like videos like this that can help you just crush it in the hand therapy world as an occupational therapist, then hit the subscribe button and enjoy the video. Thanks again for watching.